In the past, I've been frequently asked on tips on how to set up the drum kit. And I think that's a very, very important question, but also a very individual question. But dealing with that question, I came up with certain things that hold true for everybody, or are a good starting point, if you so wish, to not do anything wrong, like not be in your way and in your progress of setting up your kit and changing stuff around, but just having the mindset of setting it around you, like the basis of the drum kit will be you. It will be set up around you yourself. That's why I just have this rather empty layout here for now. It's just, I'm starting out with the pedals, obviously, and they go where my feet go. So if I put my feet on the floor, like I'm sitting on a chair, same if I would do it here, my legs naturally form a V shape. And that's exactly where my pedals go. And of course it depends if I'm playing heel up or heel down, like it depends on the technique I'm using. So naturally my right foot will be touching the pedal board around here, around in the middle of the, I say as a rule of thumb, it's gonna be in the middle of the moving part of the pedal. Whatever pedal you're using, it's like, you know, between that hinge and that hinge, like almost in the middle, that's where this part of my foot will go. Talking about the depth, right? V shape and then the depth of the pedal. And with the hi-hat, I start out with being almost on top of the pedal, like almost, you know, where there's no space anymore to that hinge, so I have better leverage. So that's basically where I put my pedals. And of course, snare drum will have to fit in here, so my V, the size of the V, the angle of the V will depend on what big of a snare drum I'm going to play. Seat height will be the next thing. So I'm sitting relaxed on my seat right now, and the seat height will greatly depend on how you kick your bass drum or how you play your hi-hat with your foot. I have a tendency to play mostly heel up. And regarding this, you know, like my upstroke and my downstroke with the knee will go around here. And I just make sure that my thigh is never going beyond a horizontal line. You know, if I imagine a horizontal line right here, then this will, even if I do an upstroke, will not pass that line. That way I have like more like a right angle situation from my torso to my upper leg, and then this similarly I have a right angle situation from my thigh, from my upper leg to my lower leg. That's a starting point, you know, that's where you can start finding your place around the drum kit. But that's definitely a place where nothing can go wrong, and it's definitely comfortable, and with the joints, thinking with the joints of your body and not dealing with the big bass drum first and then, you know, you positioning yourself behind that thing. That's not what I would recommend when this question comes up. So as you see, the seat height to me is crucial to feel comfortable. If I sit too low, then my knees are kind of above my hips, and that kind of makes it hard to lift them and feel comfortable for me. You know, there's other players who over years developed into that technique, and that's fine. For me, it's that point. If I sit too high, then I feel like my legs get too heavy, sort of from the angle. So that's where I'm from. So seat height, we got the V shape, and we got where the foot is on the pedals. Now it's time to talk about the downstroke on the bass drum pedal. Like, bass drum technique would be the next thing I want to address. So now, with the bass drum in the picture and the shoes tied, so you can see what I'm actually doing with the bass drum and how the downstroke is performed. Foot goes here, as I described earlier. So this part I'm actually playing. This is where I feel the pedal. And as you can see, the spring tension is about here. Like, I usually take them out of the box and they're fine, but I don't really adjust them in any way. It's just when I go to the head and I take my foot away, I try to get an infinite wobble if you so wish. So, you know, have it move quite a bit. That's a direct drive pedal here, by the way, but that doesn't matter. It goes with the chain drive, same thing. So this would be the zero position of the bass drum pedal, and I usually have a little weight on the tip of my foot, so I'm closer to the head with the tip of my bass drum stick. And then I first go up with a heel, and then in slow-mo, it's really hard to show, but I'm trying my best. So then I take the top, like the tip of my foot up, then I go below with my heel, and then I kick it. And to show you that exact movement in slow-mo, I will need to do this with the drumstick, like lead the tip a little bit, because in fast, it's like that. And instead of using camera techniques to slow that down, I will just show you. I'm going up here. Then I pull with the spring tension releasing into me. I pull up my toes, so to speak. And then I get the heel down. And now I have the full force of the leg behind the stroke. So the beater then hits, comes out of the head straight away. And the same instant, my heel will touch the ground. So that's the goal, right? And that's a very intricate movement that I practice quite a bit. But I think if you have that down, you understand the machinery. You totally understand what's happening with the rebound, with the spring tension. You really get to know your pedal, and it's effortless. Like once the movement is mastered, from the energy point, it's really effortless. It's really fast. At the same time, it can be really loud. So it's very controlled, but it's fast. It sounds good to me, and my foot, this part of the foot, is actually never leaving the pedal board. That's another thing that's important to me. So that whole motion, I'm going to repeat this one more time in slow-mo, helping with the stick here. I get up here with the heel, my toes get up, so the spring can move the beater towards me. Then my heel goes down underneath, and then the toes kick in. And the same instant, I hit the head here, the heel touches the ground again, and the beater comes out of it. So as I said, I'm like with the drumstick, when I hit the drum, I'm not crushing the stick into the head. So I let the head ring, especially with the tom-toms. You will notice that, you know, you're always coming out of the head, and then you have your basic position. And that's what I strive to do with this movement also. I can, of course, mesh the beater into the head if I so wished, if I want to use that other sound it makes. I just will have to, at the end of the movement, I will just leave my heel up, like so. So actually, with this kind of more open sounding movement, depending on the muffling of the bass drum itself, of course, this is very dry right now. But I can achieve that mesh it into the head sound and energy if I just leave the heel up after that whole motion thing.